Hey, hello everyone. Hello everyone. We're live finally. So today we're going to do a lot of things. First of all, probably 4 months ago, when I crossed 100,000 followers, I have promised you to make a Q&A video. Yeah, hello everyone. Hello, I see you. Can you hear me? Can you see me good? Everything is okay? Because we're struggling here with some technical features for a while. Hello. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, okay. If you can see and if you can hear me good, we can continue. So probably 4 or even 5 months ago, I don't remember when it was in April or in May when I crossed 100,000 followers, I promised you to make a Q&A video. So... Now it's already 4 months later. Just now I've got this beautiful award. I received it on, I'll close the address here. I received it on Tuesday, so I'm waiting already for 5 or 6 days to open this award. But I really wanted to do it together with you because it's much more fun when you're doing it together. Yeah, hello. I'll read your comments for a second. Hello, yeah, about the fan mail, I will explain you a little bit later because, like, I'm not really against the fan mail, but there are certain things because in Belgium you can send or receive tax-free just boxes, packages that are under 22 euros. So let's say $24, $25, including the shipment cost. So that's why I'm a little bit very careful with all these fan mails, because of course I'm so pleased, guys, that you want to send me something. And I'm sure that I would love it at all, but I'm really a little bit scared of all these issues with the Belgian Post and with all these taxes and everything. But of course you can always contact me via Instagram direct messages. Of course I don't all the time check them. I get quite a lot of them, but regularly once in a couple of days I'm checking my direct mails, and then I can explain you everything about the fan mail. So I can accept small things, but it should be something really small, not expensive, not very big and heavy for Belgian Post. So let's do it like this, because otherwise if I let my address here and I will tell, oh yeah, everybody send me fan mail, I will pay the tax for all these packages. So where I'm from, I live in Belgium, but I'm not Belgian. And here we are coming already to the first question from my list I have made here. Yeah, 12 or 13 questions that I constantly get in the comments under my videos that are more private, maybe, because questions about those I reply in my videos, but some private questions I'm going to reply now. So I live in Belgium, I live in Flanders and Flanders, but I'm originally not Belgian. I was born in Belarus, and I'm sure almost nobody knows about the country Belarus, and everybody thinks that it's Russia. No, it's not Russia. It's another country. It's completely independent. We have our own president. Yes, the same president already for 25 years, but it's not Putin. It's another guy. So I'm originally from Belarus, and my native languages are Russian and Belarusian, but for the last 7 years, probably seven years, I live in Belgium. So my daily language of daily communication is Dutch. So I'm native in Russian and Belarusian. I speak Dutch in my daily life, and I speak English when I'm traveling on YouTube, for all these international communications. Thank you. Hello from Ukraine. Hello, Ukraine. I've been there multiple times, probably 20, 25 times for sure. Wait, the comments disappeared. Comments disappeared. So now appeared again. Disappeared. So while comments have disappeared, let's probably take a look at this award. Because, yeah, I was waiting for 4 or 5 months to make a live stream and to answer your questions and not just to chit chat. But YouTube also have waited long enough, because I have waited for this award also for 4 months. But finally, it's here. And what do you think? Should we unbox it immediately, or should we wait for some more people to come online? Let's see. Hello, hello Philippines, hello Kentucky, hello UK, hello California, hello Brazil. Yeah, I know I have a lot of people from Brazil watching my videos. Probably USA and Brazil is on the second place. Romania, Austria, Finland, oh, the whole world, of course, in Europe, it's now evening, in United States, it's afternoon. I don't think we'll have lots of people from Australia and Asia, because there's probably almost morning, if I'm not mistaken. Finland, Poland. Acadia National Park, Arizona, England. Hello, 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 guys. I'm really happy I'm here online because, yeah, we had some technical issues today by installing it. So probably some of you have seen my pre-live stream, a piece of my ceiling and the lamp. So now probably I will take my knife and I will start slowly opening this box, my new super cute knife. I don't know if you can see it. Probably not. You will see it in my next video. I'm already editing it. It's my new knife for making the pencils sharp. So let's start opening the box, because I was looking at it already for really for 5 days. And I couldn't wait to see what is inside. But anyway, I have already enjoyed the box a lot, because it's so pretty and black and it says YouTube here. So it's really a pleasure to get. I can imagine we're opening it now and it's all broken there, or the name is different or something, or cracked in two. It's really not so easy to open. One side is going and... Yeah, live unboxing. I've never done live unboxing myself before. Before, I've been live just a couple of times on Instagram, and that's it, on stories. Yes, I waited for 5 days, can you imagine? But I really wanted to do it with you, but I understand that the best time to come together to sit online is now Saturday evening or Saturday afternoon for you, then we can have more people here. So, and I have opened the first part. Dun, 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 dun. And what we have here, congratulations of you on your subscriber milestone. We're honored to take part in recognizing your achievement. La 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 la. Thank you very much, YouTube. Oh my God, and there is still such a certificate and the signature and that everything. I just still keep hoping that nothing is broken there, that nothing is, yeah, and that my name of the channel is right. So let's take a look. Wow, it's not broken, and the name of my channel is correct. Look how pretty it is. Oh my God, it's literally a mirror. Look, you can see my camera, can see reflection of my lights there. Oh my God, it's so cool. Presented to Popa Natalia for passing 100,000 subscribers. I can tell you, I have certain things in my life to be proud about, but this is probably the number one award and an achievement in my life, because when I started this YouTube channel, it's almost exactly 2 years ago in October. We should put it somewhere where we can see it good. So when I started my YouTube channel almost exactly 2 years ago, in the end of October 2016, I had zero followers, zero. You know, some people, they're coming to YouTube from Instagram, for example, or so from some other platforms, and they have already some support and backup. And they're coming with a couple of hundreds of followers already to YouTube, but I had zero followers on YouTube, I had zero followers on Instagram, I had everywhere, and it was just completely new. And of course, when you're really going follower per follower, video per video, doll per doll. When you really, when the road from 50 to 60 followers is a road of maybe of 10 days sometimes, then of course now when you got already to 100,000 followers, and actually now it's already more than 100,000, now we're already at 170,000 followers, it just feels good. And you feel that you can something, and you feel that there are people that think in the same way like you do, that there are people that like exactly the same things like you. And yeah, you will never walk alone. This is the feeling that YouTube gives. And thank you guys. Thank you for watching my videos, for commenting, for subscribing, liking, for all your support during all these 2 years. And I hope this is not the last award we have won together. So let's go to the comments and let's see. Yes, I also cannot wait for my 1 million button. Thank you so much. Thank you for your congrats in the comments. Thank you so much. Yeah, how long have I been repainting the dolls? This is a question number one in my Q&A list. And yeah, I'm repainting dolls actually for 2 years. I've started probably 3 or 4 years ago. I had a period when I had a little bit too much free time and too little social connection. So I needed to do something with all this little bit emptiness around me and at the same time too much free time. So I started to make Tilda dolls. You know, it was around 4 years ago. It was extremely popular on the internet. So I was making like Tilda girls, Tilda bunnies, well, some Tilda animals, whatever. And I never really thought about making these repainting dolls. I've seen, of course, these pictures on Instagram and on Pinterest, but I always thought that it's like, I don't know, that these people who repainted dolls, they have some special knowledge, because I would never be able to paint it with acrylic paint. I was only thinking that it's with brush and with paint, so it's a little bit more difficult. And I was busy with Tilda's because I thought that doll repainting was too difficult. Then I started making Barbie outfits. And then suddenly, when I was already busy with Barbies, I've seen, I think it was video of Delightful. Catherine, hello. I think it was a video of Delightful when I finally seen that people are doing it with pencils and with a special spray. And yeah, it's a little bit turned my vision of this hobby. And I said, with a pencil, I can do it. Because of course, pencil is sharp. You can make it very sharp. It's hard. It's much easier to manipulate with a pencil than with a brush, with a very fine brush, especially. So yeah, the same week, I bought a whole bunch of used Monster High dolls. I ordered my box of 60 pencils I'm using, still using them. And the spray and all these basic things. And I've started repainting my dolls. And actually here on YouTube, you can still see the third doll of mine. Probably the first one was never posted. It was just like a tryout. I was just trying the materials, how you need to seal, how thick it should be, how long to dry, and everything. The second doll, I was already filming, but then I was a complete loser in filming. And then I was probably for a week or for 10 days, I was sitting, crying, trying to edit that video. Because when you're doing it for the first time in your life, video editing, it's difficult, guys. It's a completely new world of video editing. So it was just absolutely impossible for me to post this video, to make out of this filmed material a decent end video. But the third video, I was already experienced and in doll repainting and in video editing. So the third, my third doll ever, is my first video available on this YouTube channel. So I'm busy with doll repainting for 2 years. Yeah, and here I am in my world, thanks to you guys. So let's go to the comments. I laugh delightfully. Everybody loves delightful. She's extremely creative. And also I think it's cool because we're all different in this dolly painting community on YouTube. For example, Delightful is extremely creative in all this making things and different techniques. Other dudes, they're better in some, for example, manga or some anime style. I'm more into the contouring and face drawing direction. So everybody has his own style. I think it's very cool. And yeah, everybody loves Delightful because she's really very creative and you all the time see some new features. It's not even about painting, it's about creating the whole this look and we all love it. Yes. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. These are compliments for my curls. Will you try plus size girl in the future? Honestly, I am working the plus size doll right now. I have some special plans for her. I'm going to turn her into some more famous, a little bit famous person, the celebrity style, but I will not tell it now yet. No spoilers, but really the plus size doll will come out, I think, in September. Not next week, but probably a week later or in 2 weeks. But thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, my favorite is your giraffe doll. I'm also such a fan of this giraffe doll. It's not normal. But the next one that will come out the next week, Friday, I think it will be exactly from the same category like this giraffe doll. Oh yeah, gold button. I also cannot wait for a gold button. But for the gold button, I still need to draw and to film a lot. And you still need to comment and like and subscribe a lot before we reach. But anyway, it's already very nice to have 170,000 subscribers when you start from zero in 2 years. I think it's quite a nice prestige. At least I'm proud of myself. Yeah, danke, the commentaars in Netherlands. Yeah, plastic surgery, I can tell you. With the plastic surgery makeover, I have now a serious problem. I've tried something, it failed completely. So right now I'm sitting already probably for 4 weeks and thinking, how am I going to fix this thing? So the plastic surgery video is a little bit, it will come out a couple of weeks later because I don't know yet how to finish it, honestly. Yeah, and it was going to be plastic surgery on a big 17-inch Monster High doll. So I have to find a solution because it's an expensive doll. I bought it very expensive new, so I must finish it and make it pretty because now it's not going good. They also draw on paper or on a tablet. In theory, yes. In theory, I work with different medias, but unfortunately, now I almost don't have almost no time for other media. Yeah, I would like to draw more with pencils on paper. I would like to draw more with sketch markers. And watercolor pencils. I said it already automatically. No, I mean just normal watercolor paint is also very nice. I really like working with it on the watercolor paper, but right now I really have no time. But lately I've bought a new laptop and it can be transformed from a laptop to a tablet. And it's with the stylus and everything. So I really hope that it will motivate me to work more in some digital art and to study it a little bit more and that I will sketch a little bit more because for now I keep everything in my head and sketch everything in my mind. Yeah, let's go to the comments. Who do you have helping me? Of course, my mom is helping me a lot by making the outfits for Monster High dolls of the regular size because it's, of course, and I know, by the way, that my mom is watching out this video. Wait a second, everyone. Right now, I want to send greetings to my mama, papa, and to my cousins, and to my aunt and uncle because I know that they're all sitting now together. probably 3,000 kilometers away from me and watching this live stream. So, hello, family. Yeah, so who is helping me? My mom is helping me a lot by making clothes for Monster High dolls. Of course, my husband is helping me a lot with smaller things, like sometimes going to the post and helping in the house. I have more time for working on my dolls, but I don't have a special person for it. So I'm like one person company. I'm making almost everything myself. And yeah, so sometimes people are just helping me with other things to let me have a little bit more time for my dolls. How did your mom create her channel yet? They're really busy. She will not create her own channel. She will film it. But of course, she needs to have a good light because the ring light or some soft boxes, and they're busy now with this thing. But I really hope that the next outfit, not yet, but probably soon in October, let's say. Probably in October already I will be able to put her pieces with her videos where she's making doll clothes into my videos. So it will not be her own channel, but it will be channel, it will be something new for my videos on my channel. Comments disappear. Sorry, I'm reading, but sometimes they're updating, then they're disappearing for a couple of seconds. Yeah, since the comments have disappeared, let's go back to the questions that I have from that post where I asked you to ask me questions. Mm-hmm. Yeah, where are you from? I already told you. How did you first get into repainting dolls? By watching delightful videos. It's also, it's so cool that first you're watching someone's video, and this is really like some guru for you, some teacher, person who knows so much and who can give you his knowledge. And now, 2 years later, we're collaborating, we're communicating, and we're like a part of the same community. It's really nice. But yeah, I mentioned it already in the comments under my videos. We discussed it, that the doll repainting community on YouTube is quite friendly, especially if you see what's going on nowadays in the makeup and beauty community. All these dramas, it's not normal. And I think it's because here in doll repainting community, we're creating things. And creating things, it's quite, it's healthy for your mind, because normally you have to create a little bit more than you are consuming. And so we're creating and we have no time, no reason for frustration. We're just watching the works of other artists, getting inspired and making our own dolls. And the communities that are consuming, and unfortunately beauty and makeup community, it's mainly consuming community, everyday trying 50 new lipsticks and sharing your consuming experience. There comes frustration, there come a little bit, also satisfaction, and then people try to a little bit bite each other. So, hi from father and mother. Thank you so much. Which doll artist do you like the most? Honestly, I like on Instagram, there is a girl, her Instagram nickname is Oli Krolik. I think she has a channel on YouTube. It's called Olga Kamenetskaya, but she doesn't have their doll repainting videos. But her works are really cool. I think that from Monster High repainting community, she is making the most realistic dolls, I think. But she's not posting not on YouTube, but you can see the pictures on Instagram. Yeah, and I like all of them. I like actually all of them. It's just I'm telling one name because this is someone I still have something to learn from. I'm really looking at her dolls and I'm thinking like, it's cool. It's cool. Let's screenshot. Let's zoom it in. Let's see how it's all these eyes are made, how this shadowing is going. Yeah, but there is no actually doll artist that I dislike. It's just impossible. Everybody's creating cool things. What is your favorite medium other than those? I think still watercolor pencils, I want to say again. Watercolor paint. I really like how it works on watercolor paper, especially when it's wet and dry, and I can really do things. I really like how it looks. Now, what tips do you have for learn another language? Just learn it. Just take one book or one teacher or one course and just learn it. Because I know it already from the Dutch lessons that when someone is bringing the second book, it means person is not good busy with what is he doing. He need one course and he need to take max out of it, really like 100% out of one course of a language. Yeah. And speaking, the not be scared of making mistakes. Yeah. So what? Even native speakers are making mistakes. So just don't be scared to learn something new. What advice would you give to someone who is trying to get into dory painting? Honestly, first I would try on paper because if you can make more or less realistic doll paper, girl face on paper, on those it will go as well. It's just a little bit that you need have to spray it with the sealant and that you have to, a little bit, with these watercolor pencils. It's just a little bit some media features. But if you can draw a face and eye, lips, a little bit some contouring, all these dimension things on paper, it will perfectly go on those as well. And also the same like with language, taking and learning with drawing and painting, just practicing, every day practicing. I'm practicing for 2 years approximately every day, and I see still the progress. So it's all about the progress. And also, by the way, the best advice I can give to beginners don't is to not learn it from doll artist videos. From doll artist videos, you can take some maybe tips, some small techniques and things, but if you want really to learn to draw, eyes, lips, skin, whatever, open real drawing tutorials. They're normally like 40 minutes long, an hour and a half long. And watch them, not speed up, very long, very boring sometimes. But really, the best what you can do is really following such a very detailed and very long drawing tutorials from real artists, not doll artists. Oh, and see in the comments, my husband is already chatting to my parents. This is what is going on. Where do you live? I live in Belgium. I live in Bruges, next to Bruges. By the way, it's a very pretty city, so everybody's welcome to Bruges. Yeah, Tom is my husband. No, this wall in the background, it's actually a background. It's a soft background. Since I'm recording now in all my videos, the intro part, I have decided to make this corner to be able to sit here. So I've bought a couple of backgrounds. There will come more soon. They're not really expensive. They look so good, and you can always create a little bit different styles of your studio. Can you please make Violet from a series of unfortunate events on Netflix? I haven't watched this one, by the way. I should remember it. Series of unfortunate events. I'm watching now the latest season of the Orange is the New Black now, right now on Netflix, but I have just three or four episodes over, so I think tonight I will be done with this. So I have here some series of unfortunate events. How was your day? My day was a little bit stressy because around about 3, 4 o'clock, I realized that there are some issues with this going online on YouTube that I have need to have some special program for it. So the last 5 hours I was stressed if it all was going to go okay. But yeah, it's the first time, the first live stream. Of course, I'm all a little bit itchy. Yeah, Stranger Things are good. With YouTube, are there restrictions on characters you could create? Honestly, I don't know. I'm creating now, yeah, I'm going to create a couple of more or less famous people or well-known people. I don't know, I hope there is no restrictions about it. But anyway, other artists are making famous characters and actors and singers, so I don't know, probably everybody can make some sort of fan art, we can say. Yeah, the Kate Barbie toddler, I really want to work on her. I was looking at these dolls lately a lot. But yeah, I think I will get one in the future. Yeah, what's your real name? Yeah, my name is Marina, by the way. It's so funny. Actually, Poppen Atelier, Poppen in Dutch means dolls. So Poppen Atelier, if you translate it literally, it will be a doll studio. That's it. But it's funny that many people think that my name is Poppen, and I kind of like it already. I know I accepted the fact that Poppen has become my artistic name. So I like it. You can call my name is Marina, but if you call me Poppen, I don't mind. Especially I watched this funny video about Poppy, you know, this YouTube channel. So now it even there is some meaning in this name to me, I would say. Yeah, Marina Poppy. That's it. The comments disappeared again. The comments come back. Yeah, but many people thought my real name was Poppen, but really, I don't really mind. Yeah. Will you paint a Bratz doll? I can tell you, I'm scared of Bratz dolls. I'm just not sure if I could help them. Because with Monster High dolls, they have some disproportional features. But the Bratz dolls, they're just, I don't know, it's a little bit too much. I have one Bratz doll because I was buying lots of Monster High dolls from one person. And there was one Bratz doll between them. But I just don't know how to help this doll. I can probably, of course, shrink her head for 7 days and then try again this plastic surgery thing, cut it all off, but I don't know. I will try. I'm thinking about it, but I'm scared of them. What's the hardest thing about repaints? I don't know, it's probably just to get up and to start. You know, it's always such a fear of a blank paper. And you, before you start, you never know how it's gonna go, and you always, I'm so uncertain, not sure. You just need to start, you need to work. If you don't like, you're removing and doing it again, removing, doing again until you really like it. Yeah, stuffed toys, can you make stuffed toys as well or sewing clothes? Yeah, I was making stuffed toys for a while, I told it already. I started actually with making stuffed, like Tilda dolls and bunnies. And even now I make sometimes tiny teddy bears for my Monster High dolls. But yeah, I can make it. But of course, there are periods in life. And for me, this period is already a little bit past. Now I'm all in dolls. And now I'm thinking actively about making my own BJD doll, about sculpting it. So I'm now more moving into that direction. What do you do for a living? Actually, this. Actually, right now I'm at work. No, of course, for 2 years I was combining my job in the theater. I showed it one time. There was shopping vlog, I think, or something. It was around about Christmas time. And I was on the way to my theater and I was showing it in my vlog. But yeah, so for years I was working in a theater here in Bruges as an administrator, doing administrative job, you know, helping people in the theater who come in the evenings for our concerts and shows and performances. And I was actually going to continue still to stay for another season, you know, when theater starts in September and ends in the end of June. It's not from January to December the year. In theater, it's all in seasons. So I was going to stay there for another season from September. But now in July, I was like full-time doll artist, and it was so relaxed and it was so nice. And I felt so good as a full-time doll artist that I have decided to give myself another chance, to become really full-time doll artist, and that's it. So I stopped my job at the moment. I quit my job right now. And from the 1st of July, I'm the full-time doll artist. So this is what I'm actually doing for a living. Of course, I can combine, but yeah, it's becoming difficult because you're constantly working or at work in the theater or with your dolls. And of course, you're like this after 2 years, I felt that I can get run into a burnout. And of course, now when I have more free time, I will be able to make more dolls for you, or maybe not more dolls, but more creative dolls, because sometimes in the past there were moments when I was making dolls just, oh, damn, it's already Tuesday and I have still nothing for Friday, and then quickly. And this is not how I like making things, and especially it's not how I like making dolls. It should be a creative process. It should be a process of joy, of pleasure, and that's why I hope I will survive like this. I hope my YouTube will grow. I have a shop on Etsy indeed. I'm selling my dolls on shop on Etsy, and there is also publicity in my videos. This is approximately how I live now, how doll artists live. It's YouTube, AdSense, and plus selling dolls. And of course, my dream goal for the future. I want, and I will, of course, I hope so. And I will give the workshops online and offline, opening some sort of doll school of for doll artists, where people could learn something from me. And I'm working right now on the program of this, so that I would be able in some, let's say 2 days, if we're making a workshop, for example, for a whole weekend, I'm talking now about offline workshop, that during the Saturday and Sunday, during these 2 days, we would be able to repaint dolls with my potential students. And also I'm going to do it online. No, yeah, of course, there is still a little bit work to do, maybe around the new year somewhere, around Christmas, around January somewhere in this period, I will be able to start with online and offline workshops. So, of course, now, since I'm a full-time doll artist, I have finally time to develop all these extra branches, like, of my business. Right now, I'm just repainting, making videos, selling dolls, and in the future, I'm going still to do online, offline workshops. I'm going to create my own BGD doll. Of course, I will try to create my own BGD doll, because, it's not easy, but I hope I'm going to score it. Yeah, the online workshops would be great. I think so also. But of course, I still need to try. I still need to test it. Maybe we'll make first like some free group of free students to test things. And later I will ask some, I hope not too big money. Because a little bit gossip, tea spilling, a little bit. $1 artist, I will not tell the names. Her workshop. 2 days workshop cost $500, and her online workshop about making a wig, exactly the same like Mozakito has for free on YouTube, cost 100 euro. So no, my prices will be lower, guys. This is how I see the future of my atelier, making my own BGD doll, keep repainting Monster High dolls. So, by the way, they're stopping with Monster High dolls. What am I going to do? Of course, yeah, if there is one door is closing, another door always goes open. And if they stop with Monster High dolls, then they're going to start with something else, I guess. So, yeah. But anyway, to take no risk, I should better have my own doll to be able to repaint my own doll if all these Monster High dolls will disappear from the shops. Yeah, which size dose is the best for repainting when starting out? It's difficult to say. Of course, the bigger doll is easier because it's less precise work. It's approximately, like when I'm repainting a big doll hat, it's approximately the same like drawing on a paper, on A4 paper. Yeah, of course, the big Monster High doll is a little bit more difficult. Okay, let's start on the very first place. I would put still the big doll hats because they are big. They're approximately the same like drawing on paper. All the details you can draw perfectly, even if your pencils are not extremely sharp. Then on the second, and also these big doll hats, you don't really have to prepare very much. You need just to cut their head hair off and remove with acetone the face, because with the big Monster High dolls, the hair are almost impossible to pull out. Sometimes you can. Sometimes in my video yesterday, you could see that it was quite easy to remove the old doll's hair, to pull it out. But most of them, it's just impossible to take the doll head off without cracking the neck in pieces. It's also quite an issue, quite a thing to do. So in the first place, I would put the big doll hats. On the second place, small Monster High dolls, because they're easier to prepare. And on the third place, probably big Monster High dolls, because they're really difficult to unplug this hat and the body, and it's also difficult to pull the hair out. But if you're not going to remove the head, and if you're not going to pull or cut the hair off, if you're just going to repaint the face, then probably big Monster High dolls. Yeah, they're a little bit difficult to prepare. Yeah, I also like large Monster High dolls because they have this extra points of articulation. It's and really when the doll with such a realistic face can sit in a realistic way, it immediately makes everything double as more realistic. Because Monster High dolls, they're a little bit, of course, yeah, they're of course much better than Barbie dolls, but yeah, the big Monster High dolls are even better because they can really pose like real people, like real person. Thank you, love your hair and makeup. Thank you so much. Yeah, should we stock up with Monster High dolls? They're stopping with them. I don't really know. If they stop producing them, then kids stop playing with them, then nobody watching these videos and nobody needs actually Monster High dolls. I think it's normally like this. So I will buy lots of them at the moment for the next like year or two, but I really think that it's going to be a hole on the market. Because if Mattel doesn't make ever After High dolls nor Monster High dolls anymore, so there will be certain hole in the market, so there must come new dolls. So I think they have something in their mind, maybe new cartoon series and new dolls, maybe just a doll. I don't know. We need some insider's information. I don't know. But I don't think that Mattel will just close down the Mattel line. And that's it. And they will die making just Barbie dolls. No, I think there will come something else. Yeah, and thrift stores, they have Monster High dolls. I'm buying them online mostly because kids are growing up and the parents are selling their doll collections. And then these people can meet me when I will come and buy all their dolls. Yeah, we should start a Kickstarter for Monster High indeed. Poor thing. Do you ever work with clay? I don't have so much experience with working with clay, but of course I'm ready for a while preparing mentally and then, yeah, by getting some information and preparing for sculpting my own BJD doll. So a year ago in November I was in Prague. There was a huge international doll exhibition, something like this it was called, and there I had a course of sculpting hands and feet, because I thought if the face, in theory I know how the face is, how it all works, and so the face in theory I will be able to sculpt myself, and with all these fingers that also like express something, not just fingers like this, but fingers with some expressions, more difficult thing. And also then we had a very nice teacher who is making dolls already for 40 years probably. So then I had some, yeah, a little bit my first experience with clay, and it was fun. By the way, here on YouTube I made vlogs about it, about this exhibition, about all the dolls that were there, and about me sculpting the hands and feet, and about the end result, where what it was. So now, of course, it's something completely new working with clay, but I think it's gonna work. I don't know if you're practicing a lot, if you're learning a lot, if you're watching, if you're doing things, it's gonna go. I don't know. So what else? What is sending greetings to Mama Poppin. Oh, again, disappeared. Why all these comments only disappear when I start reading them? Appeared, disappeared. Oh my God. I just brought 60 centimeter BGD. Whoa. It's crazy. Yeah, 60 centimeter BGD. And which brand it is? Because, yeah, I told already I'm such a fan of Popova sister dolls, and also the funny dolls. I said, like, such a alien dolls are make is making Pasha Pasha brand. I think she's from USA. Oh, someone is having happy birthday. Happy birthday. Yeah, good luck with your first Monster High doll repaint. It's always an exciting moment. I tell you, even if your first repaint is not ideal, take a picture of it, take an acetone, remove it all over, and start again. Make a picture again so you can. It's not like you're buying an expensive doll, you're going to destroy it, and if it doesn't work immediately, oh my God, everything is lost. Nothing is lost. Taking an not your first doll will not be pretty, and or at least not as pretty as you would like it to be. You should be prepared for it. No, somewhat. Anyway, the second one will be much better than the first. The third one will be much better than the second. And between the first and the tenth doll will be such a huge difference that nobody would believe it that it's made by the same person. So if you don't like it, remove it. Keep practicing. Just take a picture that you can, yeah, compare your before and after results, how your skills are growing. Yeah, tutorial my own makeup. I'm always tempted to do it, you know. I like all this makeup thing so much. I like all these palettes, and oh, I like it so much. But there's so many makeup channels on YouTube. I don't know. I will maybe still, I tell you, I'm really tempted. I really want to do it. I really like watching makeup tutorials. So I think I will maybe make some mix between repainting like dolls and making just pure makeup tutorial. I will maybe try to make on my own face, repeat my own face, makeover that I've made for my dolls. So something like this. And I think the first one will be for Halloween. At least this is my plan. I'm going to repaint the big doll hat. And at the same time, I'm going to show how you can recreate the same makeup on your own face. So this is how I think I can a little bit find self-realization as a makeup artist. No, I don't speak German. I speak Dutch, but German I can kind of understand because they're very close with Dutch. And I remember some years ago I was at a theater festival in the German part of Belgium. We have Dutch speaking where I live. There is a French speaking, approximately as big as the Dutch speaking, and a small German one. So some years ago I went to a theater festival in the German part of Belgium, and there was a performance for about elephant for kids of 3 years old. There I could understand everything. I was so happy that, yeah, cool, you speak Dutch, and for free you're getting German for kids as well. So yeah, of course, when you're reading German, you can kind of understand it. Yeah, if it's too difficult, too much text, no, you cannot understand. Afrikaans, I think so. Yeah, it's also the same. It's even closer to Dutch than German. And especially read Afrikaans, I think it would go well. What about you painting animals? Yeah, what kind of animal would you like to see repainted? I don't know, like unicorn, or yeah, to repaint it should be something rubber or plastic. What about French? No, like very, very poor, very poor. Also understand some basic things, to read some basic things, but no. Maybe later. I should. Of course, I want to study all languages. I'll study and French and Italian and Spanish. It's all very useful. Spanish, yeah, one half of the world speaks English, another half of the world speaks Spanish, so this is also useful. French, yeah, it's also needed. France is here 50 kilometers away, but yeah, there are too many languages in the world, guys. Have you been to Philippines? No, not yet, but I would like to. I would love to go to Philippines or Thailand. Maybe not this winter, maybe next winter, because I've never been to the Asian part of the world, but I would really love to go one day, and maybe even quite soon. My little pony dolls. This is also the only thing I'm thinking about, yeah, repainting animals, yeah, unicorns, ponies. And I have here this Monster High dolls to Lane, the one that is half unicorn, half horse. So this is approximately an animal. It's also laying here ready for 2 years probably. I never know what to do about it. The white unicorn, I don't know. Wow, speak English and French and study in Korean. Yeah, Korean is probably even more difficult than everything that I'm speaking here. Yeah, so I speak, yeah, Russian and Belarusian is native languages. English and Dutch, yeah, quite fluent. Yeah, I am communicating without paper laying in front of me. Like sometimes, oh, about accents, by the way. I wanted to complain already for such a long time, and now it's probably the moment. Okay, I'm not a native speaker. I'm honestly not a native speaker, approximately none language, because in English I'm not a native speaker. I never even lived to UK or US or Australia. But yeah, I speak it quite fluent because I used to work for international festivals. In Dutch, I'm also not a native speaker. Who speaks Russian? Yes. I hope nobody. So, and Of course, I'm not a native speaker in English. I'm not a native speaker in Dutch. I'm a native speaker in nothing, approximately. And everybody can hear that I have an accent, and I have no problem at all about it. Because even people who speak, for example, live in Russia for 20 years and speak perfect Russian, I also can hear their accent. And it's no problem about it. But on my channel, in the comments, I get lots of negative comments about my accent, And all of them, all, okay, 99.9% of them are coming from Russians. Tell me, what's going on? Russians are always complaining about their international image, that there may be something wrong. But if from 100 Russians, 99 are saying that their ears are bleeding from my accent, I don't think there is a problem with my accent. I think there is a problem with 99 people who are all, for some mistaken reason, are from Russia, speak just Russian, and half of their comment about their bleeding ears from my horrible accent are written in Russian. So, complained. really, because every time when I see this comment in Russian saying, oh my God, what a terrible accent, my ears are really bleeding, I want to say, then go to the doctor. If your ears are bleeding, just go to the doctor. It's not a time to watch dolly paint videos with bleeding ears. Okay, something positive. thank you for, I know that that people, the native speaker people, they have no problem with my accent. Yes, you hear that I'm not a native speaker, but so what? I think we can perfectly communicate. Some people think I'm Brazilian. Some people think I'm from Romania or these like Balkan countries or Turkish or something like this. But I never get these hateful comments in from Brazilians who think that I'm a Brazilian, from Romanians who think I'm Romanian, from people who think I'm Turkish. There is never negative comments. They think, oh, are you from Brazil? Are you from Poland? Are you from Turkey? But just Russians are coming and saying, oh my God, my ears are bleeding from your horrible accent. So I think it shows something, yeah? thank you. You see, it's just important to complain and you immediately get a lot of love and compliments. Love you also, guys. Thank you. No, French, I told already. French, I don't speak. That's just teeny tiny bit can understand. Will you make an Indian doll? Yes, it's all written down in my... Now I made an African beauty yesterday. There in my list still stays an Asian beauty. And Indian, so I will try a little bit to play with the different skin colors, features, traditions, some. Hello people from Poland. Poland also, Polish, I speak also Polish. I studied it for 3-4 years in the university, but I can start very pretty speaking Polish, like first two sentences. And then my computer burns out and I'm like, so I start speaking Dutch and that's it. But the first two sentences I can pronounce really pretty. Yeah, and I can understand Polish very well. I can read Polish almost like Russian, like Belarusian. But yeah, speaking is already difficult. It's all about practice. The same like drawing dolls. Language is also about practice. Yeah, the Elements dolls, yes, maybe. I think Delightful made it. No, somebody made it already, the Fire or Hexton, no? I know, I need to look it up. Oh, yeah, Southern Belle, like Scarlett O'Hara. By the way, I've been with my parents some weeks ago, and we were looking at pictures of Scarlett O'Hara to make her with my mom, because we're preparing with my mom, planning the future dolls, and Scarlett O'Hara, yes, it was there. Hello, Israel. Hello, Denmark. Now, my name is Marina, but you can call me Poppin, it's okay. I get used to it already, I like it. Yeah, but I was thinking about, strangely enough, I'm quite easy, can create the names. I remember when I was opening my channel, it was immediately, oh yeah, it should be Poppin Atelier, because for Dutch people, they understand what it is, it's straight Poppin Atelier, doll studio, but for English-speaking people, it's something with poppy, popping, pop music, maybe something like this, so I don't mind if you call me Poppin. Oh, somebody has two dolls from me. Oh, I hope you enjoy them. I really hope you're not disappointed. I still really hope you still love them. Facebook profile, no. I used to have a Facebook profile, but I don't know, for me it seems a little bit like Facebook is too out of time. I don't know how to explain it. It's a little bit, I don't know, Instagram is contemporary, YouTube is contemporary, even Twitter is still okay, but Facebook is already, I had a page there, but I had never time or even thought to refresh this page, to put there some new pictures and information. So now I decided to concentrate on mainly on YouTube and a little bit also on Instagram, because it's sometimes easier, because it's more mobile and fast. From Russia? No, I'm from Belarus. By the way, who knows the country Belarus? Because I know that mainly people, it's really how I live abroad, so every time when people ask, oh, where are you from? I say, I'm from Belarus. Everybody, oh, it's Russia. No, it's not Russia. I explained this already 3 million times in my life, so Belarus, it's not Russia. It's a completely different country. I told it already. We have another president. It's already, oh, Belarusians are there. I see. Yay! I was born in Belarus, I studied there, and I had my first job there in Belarus, first jobs there. And then when I was 26, 27 probably, I moved to Belgium. Yeah, from the Olympics. Yeah, it's true, by the way, yes, sport and culture is the best way, by the way, to promote your country. If you have some singer or an actor or a writer that is everywhere, everybody knows about your country. Or when your athletes are good in Olympics, yes, and also people think, oh yeah, Belarus is not the same like Russia. Probably not. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I'm happy that people know about Belarus. So that doesn't really matter, but yeah. What type of paint do you use on your dolls? I use watercolor pencils, and I use special spray to seal it. First to prepare the surface, and then to protect the surface. Hello, Canada. Do you keep any dolls you make? I keep almost no dolls. There are a couple of doll hats here because I don't sell them. I don't know if they're market to buy these repainted big doll hats. I don't sell the big doll hats. And I have here a doll that was with me on holidays on Sardinia. I thought it could be a nice thing to remember the holidays. And that's it. All the rest is sold. I think I have just 2 dolls on my Etsy shop. Oh, somebody's mom is from Belarus. Yes, my mom as well. Fantasy dolls would be cool. It's a little bit, I'm tempted sometimes to make a fantasy doll, but the problem is I don't really read fantasy. I don't really watch fantasy. So I don't really have a source of inspiration. But I will make something fantasy or some fairy tale. Mermaids, vampires for sure will come. Mermaid, I was going to make, I have now a doll, there is a Monster High doll with mermaid tail. But I saw there are so many of them lately. So many people are making this pretty flexible tail. So I put it on hold for a while. Of course, I will repaint it because I have already the doll. But for now, at the moment, I see too many of them. So I will wait a little bit. Any advice for creators who hate hearing their own voice? I can tell everybody hates hearing his own voice. Absolutely everyone. When, as a kid or as a teenager, when you're recording something for the first time, you're completely shocked. You just need to just accept yourself. Not even accept yourself, just accept the fact that your voice will sound completely different from the side. And that's it. And this is how your voice sounds when you hear it yourself. That's it. There is nothing even to laugh or to hate. Just like this. Yeah, nobody likes their own voice. In our head, it always sounds a little bit different. And when we hear it, it's recorded. Yeah, it's something different and we don't like it. But it's everybody like this. It doesn't matter. What type of camera do you have? I have Canon M then I think it's this new, how we call this, hybrid camera. This is a mirror camera, but when the mirror is a digital mirror. So it's a Canon M10, and right now for streaming, I'm using some new webcam. I don't know the name, Logitech something. Oh, Laguna Blue repaint will be the next week. Oh, I already have so much light in my eyes that I start to cry already from the light. Are you surprised by the response to your channel? You know, it's all growing step by step. It's not happening in one day. I would be, of course. Oh, sorry, I'm not crying. I'm sitting in front of the very bright light already for an hour, and my eyes got really sensitive for it. So yes, I'm crying, but it's so sad crying. Yeah. So where were I? The response to your channel, because in the beginning, of course, there is almost no response at all. My first video watched, I don't know how many, 25 people probably. The second video watched also the same, 30 people or something like this. And then it's growing step by step. So between 0 and 100 followers, I was waiting for probably 2.5 months. Around New Year, I got my 100 followers and I started posting at the end of October. So, of course, it's going like step by step. So, if you had yesterday 0 and today 100,000, then yes, of course, it's a shock of your life. But if you came really like you had 1, 2, 3, 10, 15 and so far, so you're kind of prepared. When from between like 80 and 90,000 followers you were going for a month, let's say, then of course you're prepared that soon somewhere it will be 100,000 followers. But of course I'm very happy that people love my dolls, that people like watching my videos, because it really gives me so much pleasure and so much, I don't know, creativity, so many ideas. I'm constantly looking for something else to create. And it's happiness for me. So I'm happy that I can make things and people who are watching them, and yeah, we can be together like this. It's happiness. I can tell you honestly that YouTube can give you this feeling of freedom and happiness, that you really can become the person you always wanted to be. What TV shows do you watch? Honestly, I don't have a TV. We put it off already probably a year ago, because it's like that Facebook. It's even more out of time than Facebook. Because there is absolutely nothing to watch. Everything we're watching is online. I watch or Netflix or YouTube or, yeah. I don't really watch so many things. Publicity TV, no. I have my whiteboard. Yeah, I put it away because I was photographing here, and then when I'm photographing, I'm removing the whiteboard, otherwise I can wipe off all my plans. But yes, my whiteboard there, and you can see the reflection, you can see some plans for November and December already. Yeah, my schedule is completely full till the end of December, till New Year. Yeah, we're planning to display my reward. I don't know, probably for a couple of days I'm going to carry it everywhere just with me. Like, oh, go to the kitchen with my award, go to the bedroom, put it next to your bed, your award, or something like this. I know it will stay somewhere here in my studio. I'm going to make a studio tour soon, because this summer I have completely, seriously rebuilt my studio. So there came a new lights, the new background that you can see, the whole furniture was replaced, because before the closet that you can see the reflection of the wood was on this side. So I completely replaced everything, invested some money into it, but now I'm really happy, and soon I hope I will be able to show finally my studio, to make a studio tour. Yeah, thank you very much. What is my biggest dream? Oh, to have a house somewhere on the coast, let's say in Spain, for example, you know, or kind of Portugal or whatever. And where I have a house, and in this house I have a doll school, and people from the whole world are coming to me to this doll school, and they're staying in my house. In the evening, in the morning, we're first going to the beach. Then in the afternoon, we're working on dolls. I'm teaching you to make the dolls. Then we're going to eat somewhere together. Then we're going somewhere, on, for example, on tour if we live in some pretty place, and something like this. So how they call it nowadays? Bleisure, business plus leisure. So people that would come to my dream house, the seaside. And they would come back home, like after good holidays, and also having their own repainted dolls with them. So something like this combination of some art holidays, you can call it maybe, or something like this. And then I could really invite their people from everywhere, from the whole world, and we would draw together, create things together. I would show you what I can. So. Okay, but then your doll. First, I need to open it. Let's start with from online and offline workshops, and then if I see lots of happy faces of people who could really repaint their first doll and they're happy with the result, then I really think I can go for such a doll school. Yeah. I'm happy. I have already lots of students here on my channel. Yeah, I think it would be an amazing thing, because also nowadays when you're going on holidays, holidays are good, but you're sometimes have nothing to do. A couple of days here, laying on the beach, swimming, but after 3 or 4 days, you kind of have enough of it. But if you have something to do at the same time, then it's a completely different thing. I used to work for a theater festival, and then it was ideal. I traveled everywhere watching new performances. Then you're coming, for example, to some beautiful new city. You can enjoy all the touristic things, attractions. You can really have fun in this city. And at the same time, you have something to do. Have the goal there, and the same I want to have with my doll studio. At the same time, we're having quality holidays time at the seaside, and at the same time, we're getting some new knowledge, new skills. Yeah, I think it would be amazing. Yeah, I would do first an online class, of course. I will do online class, and I will do offline class here in Belgium, in Bruges. And of course, if everybody wants to invite me with my offline class to their country, you're also welcome. So I think this will become now soon, since I full-time doll artist nowadays and don't have another job. I hope that soon I will be able to make it also a huge part of my doll repainting routine, not just repainting dolls and making videos, but also teaching dolls. Yeah, Patreon for online classes. Yeah, with Delightful, we've made a collab. We are asking quite often about collab with Delightful. We made a collab a year ago for Christmas. You can watch my Christmas video and her Christmas video. And Moonlight Jewel was also with us. I know, maybe we'll make still something for Halloween together, but I don't know. I will not spoil anything. Do you want to come to the USA? Yeah, I would really love to come to the USA. And I would even say it's kind of the two destinations that I would really love to do in the near future. The first one is the Asian destination, like Philippines, Thailand, all this part of Malaysia, all this part of the world. And another part of the world is America, not just the USA, of course, first of all, but also Canada, but also Mexico, and of course, maybe South America. I don't know. I've heard a little bit things about that this is kind of dangerous place to be, but yeah, it kind of attracts me. It's far. I've never been there. So yeah, I really would love to go to America. of course, New York. It's also so funny. Everybody, I've met lots of people from the whole world when I used to work for the theater festival and film festival. And all people, they're like split into two groups. One group of people saying, oh my God, you've never been to New York. You must go to New York as the best city in the world. You would love, you will love it. You will completely get nuts there. It's so cool. And another part of the people say, oh my God, New York, no, never again. Just what is this even there? So I would really love to know which group of people I would be, the adoring one or the irritated people. Don't come to Illinois, it's boring. You know, there are lots of boring places in New York. You haven't seen my village yet. Yeah, the Bruges is pretty, the city itself, but we live 7 kilometers away because, no, yeah, in the city itself, there are horses, students, 10 million tourists per year and so far. So all families, they live a little bit outside of the city. So we live in a village 7 kilometers away from Bruges. And yeah, I can tell there is also not much to do, not so many attractions. Comments disappeared. Comments appear. Yeah, so, yeah, about, let's, while the comment disappeared, let's continue about the United States. So, of course, I would like to come to New York and to see, am I the one who would love it or am I the one who would hate it? And, of course, I would like to see another, which one is the best coast, the Los Angeles, the San Francisco, this part. And of course, like all artistic people probably want to cross the United States from one coast to another. So yeah, it's, of course, it's a dream. Maybe it will happen, maybe not, but I would really love to. Yeah, for what ages would your classes be for? No, of course, it depends on the person. It will not be completely for kids. No, let's say from 12, 14. 14 for sure. Like, of course, I'm thinking about myself, but when I was 14, I was for sure able already to draw something quite decent. So, to know, it depends on the person. So some people are quite, you know, so another person at 8 years old is perfectly adult and can draw and can accept information and do amazing things. So it depends on the person, how you feel. Yeah, historic dolls. We're also talking to my mom about making historic dolls. I even sent her some links with with all these features of historical costumes. So it will not come immediately, but I have it in my list. There will be something. When will the classes start? Wait, they don't start yet. But I really hope that, no, let's say now we're September, October, November, December, maybe December, January, let's say. We will go for online classes and offline classes. Something like this, but I will give you more information later, because for now I'm just more thinking how to push everything I'm doing in the 7 days, how to push it all in 2 days. So this is what I'm now trying to adjust a little bit, my routine, because maybe I'm doing things too long. Doll giveaway, there for sure will come one. There will for sure come a giveaway. I just need a little bit to think more which one would become doll for giveaway. Yes, I have it in my head, but sometimes it's a little bit too much. Yeah, American Indian doll, yes, for sure. I've made a Pocahontas doll, but I think I should work somewhere in the direction. It wasn't there yet. Do you work every day or do you keep the weekend free? I will show you now all my working days. I'm working every day and I'm writing down the hours. So you can see nothing. You can see that every day there is something. This is, yes, I work every day. I'm trying to work, not like, let's say, I have such a rule. Between 12 in the afternoon and 12 at night, I should work at least 4 hours on my dolls or on my videos. This is how I... Then I end up at approximately 32. Yeah, it's approximately 30 hours because sometimes it goes more, around 30 hours per week. And yeah, it's almost full-time job because in Belgium full-time job is 38 hours, so per week. So I'm working every day, but actually I could sometimes take a weekend or something. But I anyway keep thinking about it. Okay, I will tell to myself, okay, today you don't work, today you don't paint. But yeah, I will anyway sit in front of the TV or in front of my laptop and think, oh yeah, I should do this and this and this and this, and constantly write something down. So better get up and work and don't pretend like you're resting. So yeah, what do you do? I mean, how you do earn for a living? This is what I do. I told it already. Since July, I stopped my job in theater, and now I really want to make this big. Like, let's say it's already enough to live from it, but I would like to make it like make be enough for a very comfortable life, let's say, like this. Because of course, yeah, but if I wouldn't stop my another job, I wouldn't be able to develop my doll studio as I would love to do it. And I think that the doll studio has more potential than the normal job that you're doing every day and you have a boss. So better, let's invest in your own business. I think it can develop better. Yeah, to get an idea of repainting those, yeah, I've just seen someone doing it online. I think it was or Delightful or Andrea from Nicole's Dreams. They were, it was 2 years, 2.5 years ago. They were the biggest, Nicole Dreams was the biggest one, and Delightful was at that moment very, very fast going up. So they were the most like popular in that direction. Then I thought, ah, I can probably do it as well. Yeah, my shop on Etsy is called also Pop and Atelier. Actually, everything called Pop and Atelier. I don't have other accounts with different names. So if you're doubting if I have account on this social network, just type in Pop and Atelier and you will see. And on Instagram, I'm Pop and Atelier. On Twitter, that I never use, I'm also Pop and Atelier. And on YouTube, on Facebook, yeah, it's everywhere. So or so Pop and Atelier. Yeah, there are just one or two dolls on Etsy because everything is gone. They're not. Thank God people buy my dolls, and thank God I don't have to wait for months before they are gone. So nowadays, almost all my dolls are sold within, let's say, 2 hours, sometimes in 10 minutes, sometimes an hour and a half. So there are just two dolls, and I don't even know why they're not sold. This one with the wings, they're so cute, but yeah, it was a little bit posted all long ago, and then people bought not so much of my dolls. My channel was still like 10,000 followers or something. So this doll is scanning still to buy. Nobody's buying it because thinking that there's something wrong with her, which is pretty, but yeah, doesn't matter. Yeah, there are just two dolls online, the rest is sold. Have you ever thought about creating your own doll line constantly and thinking about it all the time? This is what I'm thinking day and night, how to create your own doll line. Sit and sculpt it is the answer. Yes, it's another priority of my channel development is creating my own doll line. Yeah, especially now when Monster High Dolls and Ever After High Dolls are closed down, so we should make something on our own. What's my favorite food? I'm an eater. I have two cats. One cat is eating everything, the other one is eating nothing. I'm the same like the one that is eating everything. I like all kinds of sweet things. I'm a sweet tooth. I like all kinds of croissants with chocolates, ice cream with salty caramel. It's terrible. Cheese, yeah, from normal food, I like cheese. What has been the most fulfilling doll repaint have you ever done? I don't know. It's always the last repaint is always the most fulfilling. So now is my African beauty that I turned, she made her out of a pink Monster High doll. So now she's probably my favorite. But yeah, I love them all. I don't know. You're sometimes thinking about some doll, think, oh yeah, it was my best one probably, and then you'll see another one. I don't know. That one was my best one. So I don't know. The last one is always the most satisfying. Have you ever met a fan? No, I've never met a fan, but I'm not really that often on the screen. I started to record the intros for my videos and show my face on my channel just, you know, when four months ago, something like this. So people don't really know me that well yet. And I also don't go out so much. Now, before at least I needed to go to work. And nowadays I'm just sitting in my studio drawing. I'm also such a person. I like being alone. I like when it's raining. I like when it's thunder. And then nothing pulls me out of the house. So this is it. How long does it take for your mom to make tiny clothes? I don't know. A couple of days, I believe, because she's not making them in one turn. She's busy for a couple of days with them. What is your favorite composition of a doll? Certain pairing of eye and hair color. I like ginger dolls. I like ginger dolls with, it doesn't matter, green eyes, gray eyes, brown eyes. Because when you're making ginger dolls, you can put also freckles, and freckles give extra realistic touch structure to your face. So I really, really like ginger dolls. They're almost always the most special. I don't know. Like, my mom is ginger. Maybe it has something to do with this. Greetings from Costa Rica. Hello, Costa Rica. Have you ever collaborated with another artist? Yes, I've collaborated with Delightful and Moonlight Jewel and Tamaku for the Christmas. And I've also, a year ago, and I also collaborated with Unidolls and Moonlight Jewel. Now it was special collaboration with it was called Retro Dolls US Hair Shop. So I was making a doll for Unidolls, but she didn't know it was me. And Moonlight Jewel was making a doll for me, but I didn't know it was her. So I should probably collaborate some more. I would really love to collaborate with Hextian. I think he's a really interesting doll artist, especially I really like what he's doing when he's working in realistic technique, especially his Lara Croft doll. I think it was amazing. So this is still a collaboration to come, I think, with Hextian. Yeah, doll of you, your mom, would be nice. Yeah, I will make a doll that looks like myself, for sure. I will, because, yeah, it's needed. But there is just a problem to find the mold that looks like me, but I think I found one, and I think that Wonder Woman looks like me. I think it's on such a small person, yes. This woman was looking for such a long time a doll that would look like her a little bit to make a portrait repaint, and she stopped at Wonder Woman. They play video games. I don't play video games myself, but my husband does, and I like watching. So for us, it's like we're playing together. So he likes all kinds of RPGs, so we're playing like Dark Souls, all parts, so these slash games with knights and stuff like this. So we have, we have PS4 and we have Xbox One. And what we have, VR. Oh, VR is something new and crazy nowadays. Oh, greetings to everyone from Belize. Hello, everyone from Belize. I watched once a video about Belize. It looks amazing. It's Belize with all these beautiful beaches. Yes? Top. Yeah, Wonder Woman marrying the Pope. So what? Yes, I looked at all the Barbie dolls. No, they don't look like me. The Wonder Woman. That's it. Yeah, Dark Souls, praise the sun. Right now we're killing zombies in some game on Xbox One. How it's called, husband? If you're still watching, how it's called this doll? This game when we're killing zombies. Yes, my husband plays Final Fantasy. I think he used to play almost all of them. He started still as a kid, and now he's still playing them. Hello, Turkey. State of Decay. Yes, thank you very much, husband. So, yes, now we're slashing zombies in State of Decay. I don't know, it's relaxing for me to slash zombies. Wait, disappeared. Comments disappeared. Husband, you have great taste in video games. myself, I played just Sims, but it was, well, when I was 18 years old, when I was a student of the first course of the university, I think. We played Sims, but it was also fun. We just made each other, like all our friends from our group in the university, and then we were checking out what will happen if we all have kids together, approximately. This is my personal gaming experience, it's the Sims. Yeah, though that looks like zombie, this I should do. Some missing limbs or something, this is also something that inspires me. Legend of Zelda, I've heard it, but I don't know, I cannot recall the image immediately. Yes, I know that it exists, but I don't know. Hello, France. Where you go to university? I went to university in Belarus. I studied Russian language and literature, strangely enough, but I almost never worked as a, so I can work, could work as a teacher of Russian language and literature, but I did it just for half a year, I think. Because I loved the kids, I loved my students, because I was like 21 or 22, my students were 17, and it really clicked perfectly between us. But there are also all these principles and all this, you know, paperwork, and this was a little bit annoying, it was too much. So, hello Romania, hello Australia. Yeah, thrift store Monster High dolls often have missing lips. That's true. My eyes are still thirsty sensitive. Comments disappeared. Appear. Hello, England. Hello, Russia. Oh, yeah. Hello, Poland. Oh, rerouting, yeah. Good luck with rerouting. Lately, I don't really reroute that much. In the beginning, I was rerouting almost all my dolls who sit at work. But nowadays, I almost don't reroute. Yeah, I should reroute more. Hey, Utah. Hey, America. Disappeared. Oh, we're ready for an hour and a half here online. Am I? The time flies. Hello, Poland. Hello, Scotland. Yeah, to Scotland, I also would like to go to see all these green hills and castles. There are still a lot of places to visit in the world. Was he always good at art? No, actually. I'm perfectly a self-taught person, because when I was a kid, I always loved drawing and painting, but strangely enough, I never had really no one who would believe in me. Like, everybody was, no, yeah, it's the kid, something, something, drawing, something, something, painting. When I was a kid, I was always making such a fashion magazines. I was making them myself, just buying big empty books. And I was drawing there, like, some fashion models, clothes and hair and everything, but nobody really took it serious. I don't know why. For me, it's now a little bit like, come on, if you see that your kid is constantly drawing some fashion, let him. This kid shouldn't study Russian language and literature. This kid should keep drawing his dolls. Just let this kid a little bit study more. But yeah, I never really studied art. I went to art school for a very short period of my life when I was teenager, really early teenager, like 13, 14, maybe even 12. But then it was quite boring because, okay, I love drawing portraits. I love drawing more people and figures. And there you're drawing 9 months per year. You're drawing some flowers, some pots, some, I don't know what, apples. And you almost never draw what you want, what you like, what is interesting for you. So I studied everything myself, and anyway, I ended up making fashion dolls, you see, as a kid 25 years ago, I used to make these fashion magazines. And now you see, even though nobody really took it serious and nobody believed in me, I still nailed it. So guys, just do what you want. Just keep doing. Hello, Oklahoma. Hello, are you? How old are you? I'm 34 now. Hello, Texas. Yeah, the whole world is here. It's true. Especially cool that we all have completely different time. For me, it's already at 10:30 in the evening. Hello, Germany. What's your favorite fashion magazine? I know I kind of like, of course, the style of Vogue. I cannot say that I read them a lot, but I'm subscribed to Vogue magazine in my social media. I think it's classy and Vogue, but it's not like I'm reading them very much, but I'm following some pictures, of course, to get some inspiration. A favorite fashion designer? I don't know. So, yeah, it's difficult to say nowadays. It's also changing. I liked Alexander McQueen when it was still Alexander McQueen himself. Nowadays, yes, I still like what they're doing, but I always feel that no, it's not Alexander McQueen anymore. Of course, there are big brands, like, yeah, favorite designers that I can afford, other designers that I just looking at. Of course, I like look at Chanel bags. Like, hello, amazing. Opening the website of Chanel, start which one? This one of 2000 year, amazing, very pretty. But if we're talking about something that you can afford, it's of course something more, Tommy Hilfiger, Ralph Lauren, something like this, some more affordable brands. But of course, yeah, high-end designers I like very much. Cannot buy them, but like very much, yes. Where's the comments? Comments come back. Disappeared. Appeared. Yeah, doll wedding for sure will be. And even my mom is very much enthusiastic about making, like, especially pretty wedding dress. Like, in this fashion collection, they're showing all kinds of dresses, and then in the end, like the top of this collection is coming a wedding dress. So this is what my mom is now kind of planning to do, and I'm also planning to do a 17-inch wedding Dracula. Well, spoiled everything, told her all my plans. So no, yeah, it will come in the near future also, the wedding Dracula, and then some big wedding super duper paint. The colors, the eyes of your dolls, that are light, medium, dark. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, I start always with light, and then I build up till the dark. I saw some artists, they're mainly doing dark and then lightened up. I'm going from light and then making dark and dark, and then of course on top I'm doing the highlights on the eyelids and over here waterline. Male doll, I've made it once. It was in February. It was an Olympic repaint, and he was a skier. I think I'm really happy with my male repaint. I have now a plan of another male repaint, but it's going to be also very special. I don't know if it's like male, female, but yeah, too. I'm planning to do some more male dolls. And strangely enough, I have less inspiration for male dolls. For with girls, I have such, I don't know, list of 30, 40 ideas to do in the near future. And with boys, it's always a little bit what to do with them. They're always more regular, more girls can be baba, and boys always quite regular. So it's more fun always to make as an art object. Girls are more interesting for me. No, tattoos. No, I don't have tattoos. Strangely enough, I absolutely don't see them on myself, and never at all. Already 34 years old, and I never in my life, never in this 34 years old, I didn't have even one day when I wanted to apply a tattoo on my body. I like it on other people. I saw lots of pretty tattoos, but I just cannot imagine an image that I would like to see on my body even a year later, 5 years later, 10 years later, because I don't know about you, but I'm changing every couple of years. There are always some periods in my life. And in one period, I like one, I don't know, I can have black period, I can have colorful period. I had the period when I had my hair blonde and short and red and everything. And when I was more like grunge style, and then I was more like such a candy girl from the 60s. It's all changing. So what kind of tattoo can I put on my body? I will dislike it in 3 years, and then I will look for a way to remove it. So no, I don't have tattoos. It's like not my thing. I don't like permanent things. I don't like things that are forever. I like flexibility when you can turn back still. I disappeared again. Comments, come back. Oh, well, it's already almost 11 o'clock in the evening here, so let's take three last questions and we will close down our online show, because yeah, I can talk and talk and talk and talk and talk, but it's already almost 11 o'clock in the evening here, and my husband is sitting locked up upstairs to not distract my attention from the online thing. No, the K-pop group. I know people who are really crazy about K-pop groups, but this universe, I don't know yet. Yeah, but I know it must be cool. I should still learn about the world of K-pop and the world of Korean and Asian. How the girls are, how the girls, I will not even try to pronounce all these styles that exist in Asian countries for outfits. Commissions. This is also a question that I probably should answer. I don't take commissions at all. For me it's a little bit less interesting, maybe. I don't know. For me, it's more interesting when I have something in my head, I'm going with the flow, then I see that something else would, for example, I could make some Japanese schoolgirl, and I see her in my head like this, like this, like this. But then I start painting the face, and I suddenly realize that this doll would look much better as someone else. And since I'm working for my inspiration, I can put away the first idea and continue with what calls me more right now. And with commissions, you cannot do it. And so it's more stressy in some way. It's more responsibility. It's more like when you're starting, you must be sure what the end result will be. So at the moment, I don't take commissions. Maybe I will in the future. Maybe sometimes I will feel like I need some fresh inspiration of other people. So give me your ideas. Give me your sketches and I will make those for you. But right now, at the moment, no. Right now, I'm working just from my inspiration completely. Yeah, for me, just more comfortable like this at the moment. Comments appear. Yeah, thank you. Thank you all so much for coming, for joining me today. And it's really fun. And I'm going to watch a series of unfortunate events today. I remember it already. I will look it up tonight. And thank you so much for joining me. I really love chatting with you tonight and opening these shiny things that reflects everything in my studio. And I will for sure do it again. I don't know, maybe let's gather together like once per month or something. So I really love you guys. Thank you for being with me. Thank you for sharing this first online live stream experience. And yeah, we will see each other very soon. On Friday, I'm already busy on this video, and I promise you it will be one of the prettiest dolls, like to my taste, of course. It will be very cute. It will be, again, a collaboration with my mom. So just in a couple of days, we will see each other again, and then again, and then again, and then again, and then we'll again go online. So thank you so much for being with me. Love you guys. And see you later again. Bye.